Hello everyone, thank you for watching. In this video, I'm going to introduce and demonstrate something I came up with to measure CO2 injection rates. This method is much more accurate and meaningful than a bubble counter, and it negates a lot of the problems we have with bubble counters. With this method, even if you change any part of your CO2 equipment or if you accidentally turn the needle valve, you can always adjust it back to the CO2 rate you were at before. Now let's get started. Okay, this is my CO2 flow checker. It's a 500 milliliter PET bottle with two tubes coming out the top and one long tube in the middle. In the front here, you will see a piece of tape where I have some markings. All these markings represent 10 milliliters of water. Here you have my CO2 setup, my bubble counter right here, which is feeding into my CO2 reactor back there. Let me show you how I hook this up. First, we turn off the reactor pump and the solenoid. Then I detach my hose. This comes over this side and the reactor goes on this side. Basically, I'm hooking this up like a reverse bubble counter. The CO2 travels down this tube, enters a bottle at the top and starts pushing the water level down. Water then travels up the tube inside and out over here over to the reactor. Next, let me show you how this works. Okay, I've got my timer here on my phone. It's set to 30 seconds. I'm going to turn on my CO2. And we will start the timer when the water level reaches here. It's always a good idea to let the CO2 run for maybe 10-20 seconds for the whole system to pressurize so that you get an accurate reading. Okay, so we are close and stand by. There we go. And 30 seconds later, the water level is at about 30 mils, which means that in 1 minute, I inject about 60 mils of CO2. That means my injection rate is 60 milliliters of CO2 per minute. So let me stop this. Now, this tank is about 600 liters with running a sump, so it uses a lot of CO2. For people who are running smaller and much more CO2 efficient tanks, you might want to consider making a smaller version of this. This is a normal bubble counter. In front I have a piece of tape. Again, I've marked out the measurements. You should probably do 1 milliliter markings as well. And when you hook it up, just remember, when you hook it up reverse. That means the CO2 should enter on this side, which doesn't have the long tube inside. Alright, so if you look at it from the front, CO2 goes in over here, and water travels up this tube and should go to your CO2 reactor or diffuser, whichever way you're set up. Other than that, it will work exactly the same as the big one, as I showed you in the demo earlier. And that's it. So I hope you found that useful, and please click subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to visit my blog too.